So let's look at some examples. There are certain forms of argument that are valid no matter what. Okay? There are certain forms in an argument that no matter what we do, no matter what we fill in for it, this argument will be valid. One example, there are lots and lots and lots of forms. We're going to look at two. One example is modus ponens. Modus ponens says, if P then Q, P therefore Q. Now, remember back to algebra class when you had the equations and you had the variables, and you could plug whatever you wanted in for the variable, but every time that letter occurred in the equation, you had to plug in the exact same thing. It's the same way here. Every time P appears, you have to plug in the same phrase. You can plug anything you want in, like Shmoo is a Magoo. Every time Q appears, you have to plug in the same thing. Snipper is a Pipper. Okay? So if Shmoo is a Magoo, then Snipper is a Pipper. Shmoo is a Magoo, therefore Snipper is a Pipper. Plug whatever you want in for P and Q, but you have to plug the same thing in every time. Okay? For example, another example. If Fido is a dog, then Fido is a mammal. Fido is a dog, therefore Fido is a mammal. Modus ponens says you take that P statement and you make it your second premise, and your conclusion is Q. Okay? So you take P and you say P is true, and as a result, Q must be true as well. All right? Now, in a modus ponens argument, you say if P then Q, P therefore Q. Okay? In a modus ponens argument, if P then Q, P therefore Q. All right? In a modus ponens argument, if P then Q, P therefore Q. I'm jumping up and down on this for a reason. Okay? Modus ponens, P is our second premise. This is contrasted with modus tollens. Modus tollens says, if P then Q, not Q, therefore not P. So you can put anything you want in for P, you can put anything you want in for Q, but you have to put the same thing. If P then Q, not Q, therefore not P. If Shmoo is a Magoo, then Snipper is a Pipper. Shmoo is not a Magoo, therefore Snipper is not a Pipper. All right? If Fido is a dog, then Fido is a mammal. Fido is not a mammal, therefore Fido is not a dog. Does that make sense?